Our next keynote is Andy Hsu, who's the founder and CEO of Neo Semiconductor, a company focused on the development of innovative architectures for NAND flash and DRAM memory. Andy's responsible for the overall company strategy, execution, and technology innovation that fuels the company's growth. He has more than 25 years of experience, including positions as VP of Engineering and leader of R&D and engineering teams. This resulted in the development of more than 60 products in various non-volatile memories. Andy is an accomplished technology visionary, inventor of more than 120 granted U.S. patents. He performed research in the fields of neural networks and artificial intelligence while earning his master's degree in electrical, computer, and system engineering from Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute in New York. He also earned his bachelor's degree from National Chung Kung University in Taiwan. The topic of Andy's presentation today is new architectures that will drive future NAND and DRAM solutions. Please welcome Andy Hsu.
DRAM is a key memory technology for today's booming AI era. The demand of high-density, high-performance DRAM has skyrocketed. However, the traditional 2D DRAM scaling has hit the bottleneck. It's hard to shrink beyond 10 nanometers. Two dimension is no longer enough. For the AI era, DRAM needs to go 3D, like 3D NAND flash memory. Introducing 3D XDRAM, the world's first 3D NAND-like DRAM, based on floating body cell technology. With today's 230 layers, it can achieve 128 gigabytes, which is 8 times more than today's DRAM capacity. 3D XDRAM is the future of DRAM technology.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Andy Hsu. I'm the founder and CEO of Neo Semiconductor. I'm excited to be here today and take you with me to a short ride into the future of memory. You all know that NAND flash memory and DRAM are two largest and the most important memory for today's booming AI era. They actually occupied more than 95% of the memory market. The performance of NAND flash and the DRAM are complementary. NAND flash memory is non-volatile, which means when the system is powered down, it can still keep the data. So we use NAND flash memory to store photos, music, and all our data in the cell phone, computers, and the cloud. On the other hand, DRAM is volatile. So when the system powers down, the data will be lost. However, DRAM has very high speed, so it's ideal for processing data. Today's system requires both memories, so we are using these two types of memory in our everyday life. A memory chip consists of a billion of memory cells in an array. Each cell stores 1 bit of data. Memory cell technology relies on shrinking the cell size to increase the density. When the cell size becomes smaller, more cells can be fit into the memory chip. This increases the density. In the past 30 years, the cell size shrink by 1,000 times to increase the density from megabits to gigabits. However, when technology reach 10 nanometer range, we hit a wall. The memory cell has become so small that makes it very difficult to shrink any further. So, since 2015, the memory technology scaling has slowed down, and it may eventually stop. To solve this problem, NAND flash memory moved to 3D structure. The 3D NAND has multiple layers like a skyscraper. by increasing the number of layers, it can continue to increase the density without shrinking the cell size. Today's 3D NAND already reached 300 layers and 1 terabit density. However, for DRAM, we are not so lucky. So far, a feasible 3D DRAM structure is not available. So after NAND flash already migrated to 3D for 10 years, DRAM is still stuck in 2D with only 16 gigabit density. DRAM's density has become a bottleneck for today's AI age. Why can we not create 3D DRAM like 3D NAND? Simply because their cell structure are very different. NAND flash memory's cell structure is very simple. Each cell is formed at the intersection of two lines called the V9 and the B9. This simple structure makes it very easy to transform from 2D to 3D. By just turning the B9 into the vertical direction and the V9 into horizontal layers, this 3D array can continue to increase the density by stacking more V9 layers. Unfortunately, for DRAM, we cannot do that. Because DRAM cell structure is much complicated, each DRAM cell has a capacitor and a transistor. The capacitor is used to store electrons to represent the data. The capacitor size is very large because you need to have enough capacitor to store enough electrons for data. And the transistor is very complicated. It's used to select the cell, and it's very difficult to convert this cell structure into a 3D array. To solve this problem, the memory industry has spent tremendous amount of effort to develop 3D DRAM. Recently, some companies that you probably know try 3D DRAM structures that lays the capacitor horizontally and form the transistor on the side of the capacitor. They believe by using this structure, multiple layers of cells can be stacked to form a 3D array. However, the manufacturing for this 3D array is very complex and challenging. It needs to form many components such as V9s, B9s, channels, and capacitors in different 3D structure and shapes. This cannot be formed by using today's process. For this, they need to develop a complete new process, including patterning, deposition, etching, and doping. Besides the process challenge, its cell size is very large due to the capacitors, and the biggest challenge is the misalignment problem. When forming this complicated cell structure for so many layers, it will have a misalignment between the layers. So even if this process can be developed, it may subject to low process yield. Therefore, we must find another solution. We must create a 3D DRAM with much simpler structure like the 3D NAND flash. And this needs to happen urgently in order to meet the computing need for the AI age. So, let me introduce you to our 3D XDRAM. 3D XDRAM is based on floating body cell technology. Floating body cell was developed since year 2000. The data is stored as electric charge in the floating body of the cell, so it requires no extra capacitor. Therefore, it's also called a capacitor-less DRAM. This simple cell structure can reduce the manufacturing cost. So many companies were developing it, targeting to use it to replace DRAM. However, 2D floating body cell has a fatal problem. Since its data is stored in the floating body, When the cell size shrunk, the floating body becomes smaller. This reduced the storage area, so the cell cannot store enough charge anymore. As a result, the data is lost in a very short time. This is called data retention problem. So in 2010, when the technology shrunk to 32 nanometer, the development of 2D floating body cell stopped. Neo Semiconductor redesigned the floating body cell and combined it with 3D NAND flash memory cell structure. We created a new cell which can be manufactured using 3D NAND-like process to form a high-density 3D array. This cell has a large floating body, so it solved the problem of the data retention which 2D floating body cell faced. We created the world's first 3D NAND-like DRAM. Our cell has a vertical P9 and a horizontal V9 like a 3D NAND. However, this cell uses a floating body to store the data, and it has a source 9 to achieve high-speed random read and write operation. It only uses three simple materials. The V9 and B9 are formed of metal. The floating body, Gen, and source 9 are formed of polysilicon. And the third one is a gate oxide layer. Since the 3D array has several hundred layers, the cell size is enlarged to more than 100 nanometers to allow the etching process to etch through all the layers in one shot. This will drastically reduce the manufacturing cost. And it also allows the cells to have a large floating body to store electric charge. So this actually solves the data retention problem. And for operation, this cell using the proven conditions of the 2D floating body cell. To write the data one, the cell using a mechanism called the impact ionization to inject electric holes into the floating body. This electric hole will be trapped inside the floating body, and this will turn on the path between the B9 and the source 9 called the channel. The channel will allow the current to flow through from the B9 to the source 9. This condition is called data 1. To write the data 0, the cell using another mechanism called the forward bias to extract holes from the floating body. This will turn off the channel, so the current cannot flow from the B9 to the source 9. This condition is called data 0. Our simulation result shows the write time is only a couple nanoseconds, which is extremely fast. So it can be used not only for DRAM, but also possible for cache memory. The traditional DRAM's read operation is destructive because it's using charge sharing. So during the read operation, the data will be lost from the capacitor. So after each read operation, it requires an extra write operation to write the data back to the cell. For comparison, 3DX DRAM's read operation is non-destructive. It uses current sensing rather than charge sharing. So the electric hole stored in the floating body will not be lost. This eliminates the extra write operation. So it will increase the read speed and reduce the power consumption. Besides that, 3DX DRAM has a unique dual gate structure. Each cell has a front gate and a back gate. The front gate can be used for read and write operation. The back gate can be applied with a negative voltage to attract electric hole inside the floating body. This will greatly increase the data retention time. Our simulation result shows the data retention time can meet the requirement of DRAM applications. To sum up, NEO Semiconductor's 3D XDRAM's operation is high speed, non-destructive, and it has long data retention time. And one of the most important features of 3D XDRAM is that it can be built into a large 3D NAND-like array with billions of vertical bitlines and hundreds of layers of word lines and source lines. Our array can achieve a high density that 2D DRAM can never reach. And most importantly, this array can be manufactured by using today's 3D NAND process with only slight changes. So we actually skip the big challenges of developing a whole new process, and we dramatically shorten its time to market. By using a mature process and the materials, we tremendously reduce the cost and the risk and the time spent in developing 3D DRAM. Now, let me introduce you to how 3D XDRAM is built. First step is to deposit hundreds of polysilicon layers and nitride layers. Then we use a deep change process to etch through all the layers to form vertical bitline holes. This is the only step that requires a photo mask. All the rest of the process will be applied through the bitline holes without using another mask. This is called the self-anneal process. And next, we're using plasma doping to form the floating body in the polysilicon layers. This is the step that 3D NAND flash process doesn't have. Then we deposit the polysilicon layer on the sidewall of the bitline holes. This forms the drain region of the cell. Then we deposit the metal to fill the bitline holes. This forms the metal bitlines. The metal bitlines have very low resistance, so it can increase the speed. And it can also help cooling the array. These metal bitlines can function like heat pipes. When we re- and write the cells, the generated heat can transfer through the metal bitlines to top of the array and then dissipate to external. This can greatly reduce the temperature of the chip. Now the array is ready for forming the word line layers. First, we use a wet etch process to etch all the nitride layer. This forms slits between the polysilicon layer. Then we use atomic layer deposition to form a gate oxide layer on the surface of the slits. And then we use metal deposition to fill the slits with metal. This forms the metal word lines. Now the 3D XDRAM array is complete. So the entire process requires only one mask and the 8 process steps. This will greatly reduce the manufacturing cost. Plus, this process is self-aligned, so it can avoid misalignment between the layers and achieve high process yield. And third, this array can be manufactured using 40 nanometer process, so it does not require EUV machines like traditional DRAM. This can save a lot of manufacturing cost. This is the first time in semiconductor history that 3D NAND and 3D DRAM can share a similar process. It allows both memories to be manufactured in the same production line or even on the same chip. So in the future, when this process increases the number of layers, both 3D NAND and the 3D DRAM's density can be increased together. And one more important thing to emphasize is the delay caused by 3D array. When implementing 3D DRAM, The delay caused by 3D array need to be considered. In a 3D array, the vertical binaries are connected to global binaries located on top of the array. These global binaries are very long, so they will cause long delay. This kind of delay is okay for 3D NAND flash memory, but it's not acceptable by DRAM. So what can we do about it? To solve this problem, we use our innovative architecture called XNAND. XNAND architecture can divide the array into many small blocks. This will greatly reduce the global binary length to shorten the delay. Without XNAND architecture, 3D DRAM will have a very slow speed. Therefore, 3D XDRAM plus XNAND architecture can provide an ideal solution for high-density, high-speed 3D DRAM technology. Now, let me show you how large-density 3D XDRAM can be achieved. By using today's 3D NAND process, the estimated density of 3D XDRAM with 230 layers can achieve 128 gigabits, which is 8 times more than today's DRAM density. Not only that, the density can be continuously increased in the future by stacking more layers like a 3D NAND. This will once again extend the Moore's law. According to the industry prediction, 3D NAND will reach 1,000 layers in 2030. This will allow us to build a 512 gigabit DRAM chip. And in the future, when the technology can produce 2,000 layers, we may be able to see a 1 terabit DRAM chip. Isn't this amazing? So, until now, I show you only the basic cell structure of 3D XDRAM. Now, let me share with you some new cell structure that will probably surprise you. The 3D XDRAM cell structure can have additional features to enhance its performance. For example, the floating body can have a separate channel and a storage area. This will avoid the recombination of electrons and the holes, and it will greatly increase the data retention time. Or we can have a hetero junction like a silicon germanium inside the floating body. That will create a quantum well to trap electric holes, so it can have longer data retention time. And another amazing thing about this cell structure is that it can be extend the applications to many other memory technologies. For example, replace a gate oxide layer with an ONO layer. This cell can trap electrons in the ONO layer and become a 3D NOR flash memory. By adding a resistive layer to the cell, this cell can become a 3D RRAM. By replacing the gate oxide layer with a ferroelectric layer and adding a diode to the cell, this cell can become a 3D FRAM. By adding a magneto-resistive layer to the cell, this cell can become a 3D MRAM. Similarly, this cell structure can be applied to 3D phase change memory and 3D tunnel effect floating body cells, and the 3D thyristor cell. So all of these cells can be manufactured by using 3D NAND-like process. So this cell structure can open a whole new world of high-density and low-cost 3D solutions to almost every type of memory except SRAM. And now, listen to this. The impact of 3D XDRAM is not only limited to memory. it will provide great benefit to AI applications. An AI chip consists of a GPU and many high bandwidth memory, HBM. Each HBM contains multiple DRAM chips to allow the GPU to have many DRAM to run the AI algorithms. So the performance of AI chip is highly dependent on how many DRAM it has. For example, the latest AI chips from NVIDIA and AMD has about 200 gigabytes of HBM. With 3D XDRAM, the density can be drastically increased by 8 times to 1.5 terabytes. This will greatly enhance the performance of AI chips. Okay, let me repeat. Our 3D XDRAM can increase the density by 8 times to 1.5 terabytes, 8 times of what is in the market today and used by NVIDIA and AMD. So 3D XDRAM is going to drive the next AI revolution. As today's AI chips simply do not have enough onboard memory, the data needs to be transferred back and forth between the onboard memory and the remote memory in data centers. This remote memory computing causes long delay, huge power consumption, and limited performance. Our 3D XDRAM will provide large onboard memories. That makes the AI chip local memory computing dream come true. This will greatly enhance the performance of AI application such as ChatGPT. With our local memory computing, we will open a whole new world of AI application that we cannot even imagine today. We believe 3D XDRAM will not only change the memory industry, but it will also revolutionize the AI industry and the entire world impacted by it. I hope you all enjoy today's looking into the future. For sure I did. Later today, I'm participating in a 3D DRAM panel discussion with other industry experts. Please join us in the ballroom C at 3:30 to get more insights. Also, please visit our amazing booth, number 215. Thank you all very much.
Thank you, Andy Hsu, Neo Semiconductor. Incredible.